Hey guys, welcome back to the Game Replay. I'm Dave the Usher. The game we're playing is Star Ocean, Integrity and Faithlessness for the Sony PlayStation 4. Okay, we've had our opening and we've seen a couple characters, but we still don't really know how things work around here, I guess you could say. No problems here, man. So, let's see. I say we ascend the staircase. But we can check out the... Well, yeah, it looks like it. This place can stretch on. I wonder how big everything in this game will be as far as where we, you know, the places we go to and the things we visit and cities and neighborhoods. Neighborhoods, you know. Women and children, take refuge. Yeah, man. Ah, there's our buddy.
I can't stand this. I'm about to pull my hair out from all this stupid waiting.
Really? Why?
All the men are thinking the same thing. If no one attacks, we're the ones that are gonna pay.
Still, I'd say that's preferable to getting raided.
Think we can hold out?
Maybe once at most. Depending on their numbers.
Once at most?
Yes. Both the men and the village itself would be hurting by the second time.
What'll we do?
We'll ask the capital for reinforcements. Either way, let's not get ahead of ourselves.
Take the women and kids to the training hall.
Gotcha.
Fellow townsmen, prepare for battle!
Whoa! Hey, look at this! Okay, let's take this seriously. Oh man, there's a lot of them. Let's take this semi-seriously. So, you know, you got your weak attacks, your strong attacks, your blocking. There's a lot of dudes here. There's a lot of action going on in the screen. Oh. I think for battles, zooming your camera out as far as you can is probably the, I think that's my ally. I think that's a good guy, yeah. Zooming your camera out, I think, is a good idea, though, for battles. So, would any of you guys consider this similar to... the Tales games? Because I kind of get a vibe like that a little as far as the battles go.
Head for the training hall. That's where everyone is.
Whoa!
Yeah,
in part one, you know, the tutorial, the battle tutorial and all, is talking about strategies and nothing too crazy, but there was a couple of things, pointers and all that. But these battles are pretty just like, whoa, man, crazy clumpage with stuff flying around. So I did good? Good enough. Wish we had a jump button. We do not have a jump button, do we? I see a lot of... Did she tell me to go someplace? I see a lot of places we can't access. Man. No jump button. Rah! I want to kill that guy. Man, why? It's probably a good idea to head back then, huh? We're under attack! Look at these guys.
I can't take this. Fidel, it's you.
My duties lie elsewhere. Keep hidden until this all blows over.
I don't know where we should go here. What about Mr. Mayor? There wasn't a star on the map. I don't think there was. Here we go, though. A preemptive attack. Oh, nice. It's getting a little, it's getting a little bright out. Looks kind of cool. Preemptive attack, man! I think my wife would dig this game. I brought up, the Tales series because, my wife plays a little bit of those. Got, like, a couple characters. I'm a little unfamiliar with the Tales finished. A little unfamiliar with the Tales series.
You're hightailing it out of here!
Yes! We did it!
Dead end.
We won!
Here's the result.
Yeah, somehow.
So yeah, a little unfamiliar with the Tales series, but I think the battles are kind of the same. Would you agree? Members out. Hey, you're kicked out. Man, sorry, kid. Sorry, kiddo. Kicked out of here.
The village lives to see another day.
Thank you ever so much for all you've done for us.
We may have fended them off for now, but who knows what'll happen next time.
Next time? You're saying they might come again?
I think so.
Please tell me that's not true.
So, what's next? If I know you, I take it you have some kind of plan?
We'll ask the king for more troops.
More troops? A splendid idea.
I'll depart at once.
I don't like this mayor guy.
I guess I won't be hearing any more of your quips for a while.
That make you sad?
More like relieved.
Damn, you're cold. Come back in one piece.
What was this guy's name again? I can't talk to him? Ted, that's right. What? I know parting is such sweet sorrow, but see you later, Fidel. Oh, okay. I'm a little unhappy that these text boxes go away a little too quickly. I'm sorry, man. This is the training hall. I don't think I'm going to be spending a lot of time in here. Ooh, look, food? Oh, look, food! No, but seriously, I don't think... It's probably about battle tips and tutorial stuff. Master, please allow me to teach you how to train.
Whoops.
Whoops. See, this is for the person who reads things to themselves, not out loud. When you read things out loud, it takes longer. It's just one of those things. What? What? Dude, why? Why? Why can't I open the treasure chest? I want to hit the bag. Maybe because it's locked? Didn't say that, though. That's annoying. Well, it looks like this place turned out to be not quite what I thought it was going to be. I thought there'd be a bunch of people.
Hello there, young Fidel. We're going to tell you how to do things, even though you're really skilled.
It's like that in all games, right?
Sorry.
Like Cloud in Final Fantasy VII. How do you use materia?
I know how to use it. I'm Cloud. I'm an ex-soldier.
Oh, let's check out the materia tutorial now. All right, guys, what do you think we should do? Mayor's place. We're going up. Might as well head out. Pretty sure I don't have a lot of cashola. Over 1,000. What is the cash called in this world? You never know, right?
Pardon me.
Hold on. I think this game could be a charming game. We'll see. Infirmary. Why, if it isn't Fidel? Dr. Miller never runs out of nice things to say about your father. What point do you serve? Kind of like the way the mages look.
Pardon me.
If they're, well, probably not called mages, huh?
Pardon me.
Pardon me. I'm gonna get out of here. I'm gonna play it fast and loose with this walkthrough, you know? Let's get to it, and let's just do things. I kind of don't want to dick around and waste a lot of time. Let's get to it. That's how I'm gonna play this one. Yeah, man. Good call.
I hope you know I'm coming along.
Huh?
To the capital, with you.
Don't be stupid, Miki. Go on home. Hey, wait a minute. Don't you understand how dangerous it'll be?
That's exactly why I'm going. You could barely handle things last night. I could never let you go alone.
Don't be selfish.
And if I somehow do get in trouble, I know you'll save me from it.
Really, Miki?
If you won't take me with you, I'll go by myself. Maybe I'll get captured by sleazy bandits. Maybe I'll get attacked by savage beasts. But I'm still going. End of discussion.
See if I care.
So you're Miki.
Okay, you've made your point. Take you with me.
Yes!
Under the condition that you make sure to stick by my side.
Okay.
Member in. Changing characters. You can switch between characters during battle by pressing some of the directionals left and right. Once you change characters, the one you were previously controlling will perform actions automatically in accordance with the game's AI. You can set the AI mode of your characters you do not control to one of the following options. Auto will perform actions even when you do not control him or her. Manual will not perform any actions unless you control him or her. You can toggle this setting for each character by using up and down on the directionals while you control that character. The default setting for this option is auto. Every time a battle concludes, you will automatically take control of Fidel, regardless of who you are controlling in battle. Is that a good thing or a bad thing? I wonder why they would do that. Because, alright, I'm going to be this character.
We're going to switch you back to Fidel every time.
I think every game player may not like that. Once a new battle begins, however, you will immediately resume control. You guys can totally tell when I stop for my breaks, I really don't even skim ahead with my reading. Once a new battle begins, however, you will immediately resume control of the character you were using at the conclusion of the last encounter. Oh, well, thank you. I guess they just kind of want Fidel to be the front guy when you might be talking to people, like it's his story, you know what I mean? Does that make sense? Maybe that's what they had in mind. Roles can be set for each individual character, and the roles characters play in the party affect their attributes and how they act during battle. You can make battles much easier by setting roles that play off each other, and you may set up to 4 roles per character. Please note that the potency of certain role-specific factors may vary depending on the role, even if the effect is the same. You can change characters as roles from the Set Roles submenu under the Roles selection in the main menu. You can set a particular role for any character once you learn it, but only one character may use that role at a time. When you set a role for one character that is already in use on another, the role will automatically be removed from the previous character. How many times did you guys say roles? Roll. Pressing the triangle button during battle will bring up the battle menu, which contains various options that will aid you in your martial endeavors. As long as you have the battle menu open, the battle will pause. Access the following submenus to perform the corresponding actions. Signaturgy, select spells, items, using items, rolls, set the rolls, battle skills, boppity boppity bop, come on. It's also possible to change what character you control while the battle menu is open. Use this option if you want to make a change. And you can hold up to 20 of a given usable item at a time. All weapons, armor, accessories, and valuables are unique, however, and thus you can only possess one of each at a time. As for any other items, you may carry up to 99 of each. Anytime you obtain an item of which you already possess the maximum number of allowed it, it's... see you later. Moreover, you may possess up to 999 items in each category. In the event you acquire items that would put you over the category limit, you'll be asked to choose something to get rid of. Finally, please remember that you will lose any items that exceed these limits if you close the... how many items are we going to be getting? Signaturgy is a type of battle skill that allows you to cast spells that rely on the power of signets. Only certain characters, such as Miki, can use Signaturgy. Characters who rely on martial arts like Fidel cannot. As with some special arts, see, this is what I'm talking about. We just need to get out there and do it and be like, hey, what's this? Oh, I can't. Hey, why doesn't that work? Oh, you just need to get out there and do it yourself. I just feel like it's better to learn that way than, like, learn this way. Like, all right, let's read this and absorb this. And then, now I know how to be an awesome fighter in the game. No, man. As with some special arts, you can cast signature, signaturgy by holding down either the X or circle button. Beware, however, that you may only map spells that target enemies to these buttons. Unlike special arts, though, you can also open the battle menu and select the signaturgy section to cast signaturgical spells you have learned. By selecting the set battle skills section of the battle menu, you can control, set whether or not characters of whom you are not currently in control, and then do other stuff, and, okay. I can't take it anymore. I'm sorry. Yeah, give me items, purchase items, thought so. Let's see here. At least there's no side quests for now. We probably need some berries. They hold a lot. What's raw fish do? 10% HP. Plump and succulent. What do we do with this? So, HP, MP, and, what's this, shellfish meat?
Uh-huh.
Plump and succulent. It's good. Only downside. Probably do some stuff with it. 30% HP and MP. Alright, let's buy some of that here. Ah, yes, that's right. Sage. We have 5. Cures poison, yeah, we should get some of this stuff then. I have no idea what's out there. Oh dear. Should have saved a little to get at least one, but okay, we'll be fine. Right? Will we? I don't know. It's always good to have a lot of cashola on hand, which I intend to do when, you know, I can do some leveling up off the clock. I don't have to bore you with that stuff. Don't have to bore you with that stuff. Welcome! I have things! So, definitely don't have any money for this stuff here. Longsword for him, the wand for her, this protector. It's a rubber. Stall cloak. Alright, I'll come back. Obviously, we're gonna be exiting and, like, going out into some... I'm predicting a big field. What if... Man, it would be cool if these doors open and it's, like, crazy snow fields and stuff. That would be cool. But no, I'm predicting, like, grassy field stuff. You ready? You ready for the grassy field stuff, man? Because I'm going to take you there. Oh, no. Skill points. Skill points, denoted by the little crystal icon, are a form of currency required to learn and hone specialties and roles. They are acquired at the end of a battle. Yeah, skill points. As specialties and roles are integral to a... adventuring on Faykreed, it is in your best interest to increase their benefits by actively expending skill points. To view how many skill points you have acquired, look at the top of the screen and check it out. Okay. Oh, look, there's more. Learning your roles. You can unlock new roles by having new members join your party, progressing in the story, or leveling up certain other roles. Simply unlocking a role, however, does not allow you to use it.
Duh, dummy.
You must first expend number of skill points. Yeah, use skill points, learn it. The roles active at the conclusion of a battle become honed and they level up after a certain amount of honing. In addition, you may level up roles by expending skill points. This may be done by selecting learn roles under the roles section of the main menu. And then you can unlock stuff. Oh no, this is the same one. Specialties are skills. Did we read this one? Specialties are skills that give your party advantages, not necessarily associated with battle. For example, some allow you to acquire certain items, while others will give you information on the minimap. They can be unlocked by various methods and are learned or leveled up by expending your skill points. Ah, look, here we go. Specialties. You can view your party specialties and level them up in the specialties menu under the skills section of the main menu. Although most specialties are passive and take effect immediately upon learning them, press the square button while in aforementioned menu to use the ones that must be activated manually. Oh, good. More. I'm glad. Harvesting. Sorry, guys. Examining the types of glowing spots pictured below scattered throughout the world allows you to obtain different kinds of items. Green, harvesting spots that yield plants and fruit. Yellow, excavation spots that yield natural resources like ore. Blue, fishing spots that yield marine life. While the harvesting specialty allows you to harvest from certain locations, you must learn excavation and fishing ones as well if you are to identify and harvest from all the possible locations in the world. You can learn harvesting right away as long as you have the SP, but you cannot unlock excavation and fishing until your progress in the game. Until you progress in the game. Finally, the higher the specialty levels are, the more you can gather. I gotta be honest with my feelings. It's a turnoff. I'm very flaccid. That looks nice. Man, aren't we lively? Ba-da-ba-ba-da-ba-ba-da-ba-ba-da! Yeah! Yeah! Psych yourself up, Dave! Come on! Woo! How's the... Oh, here we go. Stall. Stall. And then... And then we're going over to the coast of Minos. So, guys, let's not call it a wrap until we check out what's going on out here. Save spot, right? Yeah. I'll do that now. Hey, look, this is me saving my game. Yeah, save, man. And then this is what happens. Really? That's interesting. Thank you. You know, I'm 33 years old. Yeah, yeah. And maybe I'm more of a fan of older RPGs. I'm a product of, you know, the old SNES and Sega Genesis days with RPGs, really SNES, and then the original PlayStation, and of course we move onward and Final Fantasy X and all that, but that's just me. Anyway, encounters. Once you either attack or are attacked by enemies while exploring one of four, you will have, you can encounter stuff, preemptive, they're like ambush attacks probably, yeah, surprise attack, battles will end once you have eliminated all the enemies. Holy shit! Dude, they're changing the rules! And at that time, you will receive an amount of stuff. Oh, okay, for the performance. That pisses me off, actually. I hate that. I hate that. Reminds me of a certain trilogy. Once you... Oh, no, that's okay. See, I hit the X button on page 4, and that goes back to page 1. Only closing will really get rid of it. Escaping. By moving your characters outside the blue line representing the perimeter of battle, the escape gauge will display and begin to fill. During this time, your allies will continue to fight. Once the escape gauge completely fills up, your party can safely flee from battle. Woof! They will not, however, receive any EXP or fall for their efforts. Yeah. Okay. Occasionally, the battle perimeter will be red instead of blue in this event. Can't flee, Brit. I think you can tell. I'm kind of over it. You know, I think you understand. Show me what you got. So these are crabs. I am going to Atlantic City, New Jersey, for the Fourth of July weekend. Hello, everybody. How are you? I'm an American. We celebrate the 4th of July here. Do you? And I bring this up because I can't wait to eat some crabs, man. Atlantic City, New Jersey. I've never, you know, I'm an East Coaster. My wife is not. She's never been there. She's never done the whole Atlantic City casino stuff. I was married in Vegas, specifically the Red Rock Hotel. Man, it was a great wedding. Look at these things. I'm not going to eat these things. This is what I do. This is what I do on my RPG game walkthroughs. I talk about the monsters and how... I would like to eat some of them. I definitely don't want to eat these. So, here we go.
That's all you got?
You did it!
We'll find our way around here. So I was saying grassy green fields kind of stuff, but we're kind of down. You know, I should have known because we were near the water. So it's not like a, well, it's kind of a beach, but it's more like a rocky terrain kind of thing. You know, like more treacherous landscape kind of. I like it. No, this is actually way better. I just thought it'd be like, all right, we're starting out. Let's give them the boring grassy field stuff. Yeah. Knock them on their backs. So listen, off the clock, I'm gonna check out some things like, you know, set roles, set...
I wouldn't be here without training.
What's this? Oh, can I open this one? Set some roles, set some... whatever. Set up the setup, right? Understand it better myself. I can tell you about it a little bit. But I will say, I'm playing fast and loose with this one. Boom, 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 boom. The music is lively and bouncy and fine. Okay, so I thought so. You see, the other chests look very plain. This one's fancy. Can't open it. It's locked. Why didn't they use the little cross-out circle again, huh? Because they want to tell you it's locked. I need a key. Where's this key? Anyway, can't wait to go to Atlantic City. Leaving this Friday. Coming back late night on Monday. You guys care, I know. You're gonna... Man, sometimes blocking's just like, well, you can block that one, but then another one's gonna... I tell you guys this because, I don't know, man, it'll be fun. Maybe I'll shoot a little video footage of certain things for you, you know, I don't know, something, right? There we go. Double slashed him. By the way, I just character changed, and, oh, well, the battle's finished, so, there you go, goes back to him. Now, if I get into another battle, it'll go to her, right? Let's check this out then, right? So, hello, alright, flying fish. So I'm her now. So she can target... guard break. Little character change again. Switching automatic. I better get in there. I received the trophy. Who cares? Yeah, I need to get some weapon upgrades and armor upgrades. That's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna do some battling. Here, attack me. Oh, you punk ass. There you go. Maybe I'll shoot a little footage for you. I don't know what we'll do down there. Yeah, neither of us have done East Coast casino stuff, man. You know, the Atlantic City casinos and hotels, all that stuff. Vegas is actually kind of a second home to me. Lived there for about, how long? Several months in the summer of 2013 when I was dating my wife. Now, or back then. Casinos in Vegas, man. Crazy place. Living in Las Vegas in the summer, I would not recommend it. I wonder what the temperature is right here, right now, then. What do you guys think? I think it's very kind of a neutral.
I wouldn't be here without training.
Like, not hot, but not cold. Like 60, high 60s, you know, something like that right now. A little mild or something. What's this? What does that mean? Oh, no. We want this map. So I'm shooting around all ends here. The pink thing, that's the saver. It's the save spot. I gotta tell you, it's a little disappointing. Oh, crap! I gotta leave right now! I need to leave the house! I'll just save my game. Oh, crap. Well, hold on. Hold on. I gotta go back to the crystal thing. Like, that sucks. That's, you gotta go all the way back there. I know, I'm not trying to, like, be a complainer. I'm just pointing out what it is, you know? Like, can't do an autosave. It's kind of the norm nowadays, you know? I was talking about this in part one, back in the day with, playing good old SNES Final Fantasy II. And how, at first, I didn't know how you could save on the world map, and it made things harder on me. And then I figured it out. I was like, oh man! I was so happy. Oh. So you keep going around, walking around here. Hopefully you find like a chest or something. Let's get close to our destination. For the next video, I'd like to... Oh, hi, guys. Oh, you know what? I'm gonna run. So where's that blue line or whatever? Isn't there... maybe I missed it. Here, all right. Hi, guys. How you doing? Actually kind of going down the way, Anything down here? Oh, here we go. So, as usual, guys, the typical way all these RPG games go nowadays, for the most part, are a lot of tutorials at the beginning, you know, because there's always every... well, the majority of these RPG games have different configurations and setups in the way you fight and use items and do things, skills, and etc., etc. Although, I think we can all agree that a lot of this seems pretty familiar to other certain games, other genres of RPG games. I can just see some similarities with the Final Fantasy XIII trilogy, because come on, man. But, you know, they're all different, and I think the best way is to just get out there and experience it yourself. Even if sometimes, if it takes you longer. I like doing it that way. I don't know, I'm weird maybe to some of you. These guys, speaking of Final Fantasy XIII, they don't look familiar. These enemies. I got a bad feeling about these guys, these land turtles. Oh, that's not good. I think. I don't know, should we be... A double slash seemed to work. Should do that more often. Yeah, Dave, rely more on the double slash. You got it, use it. There you go.
That's all you got?
We did it!
Big dudes. Big dudes go down. Bum, 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 bum. Good thing about an RPG game. Something's hard? You know, why don't you level up a little bit? And then maybe things will go a little better for you. Didn't come down here. So yeah, a lot of item stuff seems to be a trend too. I'm very excited about exploring this world, seeing where else we're gonna be going. That'll be fun. Having some new characters. She doesn't annoy me so far. You'd think she might. She's not too peppy. They always make the little girl character like crazy peppy and annoying. She seems okay. You're okay there, kid. Die, fish! Yeah, man, Atlantic City. I'm excited. What are you guys doing for the 4th of July weekend? Hey, even if you're not an American or whatever, you know. What are you doing this weekend? For us, it's a three-day weekend. My wife's excited. Yeah, it's a little mini vacation. Who doesn't love those? It'll be fun.
I wouldn't be here without training.
We're gonna hit up the beaches. We're gonna hit up the boardwalk. We're gonna check out the stores and the casinos. We're gonna be staying at the Chelsea Hotel. That'll be nice. It's a good hotel. Some of you may have a lot of experience with it. I mean, come on, it's Atlantic City. Atlantic City Boardwalk. Yeah, I've done Jersey. I've done... done a lot of Jersey stuff. Done Maryland. Been to Maryland. All that boardwalk stuff. Sea Isle. I don't know. Whatever. Yeah, not the casinos of Atlantic City. Not really. So this will be fun, man. So what are you guys up to? I don't know. Leave me your comments about anything I discuss. Go for it.
Great job. Well, let's keep moving.
All right,
who's next?
So, I'm kind of wondering what happens when we approach a place. Will it? Ah. Let's just see where we're gonna be taken. There should be a safe spot over here, by the way. Oh, the coast. Oh, well, there's a... there it is. There's a safe spot right there. Okay, let's check out the map here. Oh. I always hit the wrong button for the... there's kind of two map buttons. Well, oh, there is Medoc. Ooh, this stretches on a little more here. We have to go through the passage on the cliffs. And here I thought we'd be ready for the next part with, like, a new, I don't know, town or some kind of place. Anyway, guys, I'm going to call it a wrap right here. I'm going to do a little tweaking off the clock. And what I mean by that is adjusting my stats and stuff. You know, getting some more money, going back to the previous location, buying some upgrades, and familiarizing myself with this game a little more. And then maybe I can familiarize this game with you a little more. Anyway, I'm going to call it a wrap right here, guys. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe. Of course, some of those comments, tell me what you think. Like always, everyone, you can follow me on my social media and my Patreon. The links to all that is in the video description below. I'm Dave the Usher for the Game Replay. Stay tuned for the next part of Star Ocean, Integrity and Faithlessness. I'll see you guys next time. I am out.